And then, after the boy laughed at the silly spaceship, there was a long and awkward pause, but eventually another man had the courage to start laughing as well. Then another. And then another. And even Billy Armstrong from Ohio stepped up. He slowly held up the photo of the spaceship, using his right hand, and showed it to the villagers. The crowd gasped and turned their attention to Billy Armstrong, who had stood up in an old wooden box and began speaking. "Fucking look at it. It's fucking stupid. The fact is, we all thought that this went to the moon for a very long time now. How? I know not. This is a question for psychologists. I think my great uncle Neil was telling a few fibs, mainly because he was coerced into it. This wasn't a bad fib. Unlike my uncle Lance's. Remember the cycle race fib? Remember the guy who cycled to Japan and back that day? Just to buy himself some decent food when we ran out? He wasn't even out of fucking breath. How do you think he did that? His fib was much more of a selfish one. Remember when he said, I don't take performance enhancing drugs, I don't take EPO, I don't cheat. But he did. He also kept all the noodles to himself. That Uncle Armstrong, I've turned my back on. Great Uncle Neil's lie was much more noble. Maybe he was trying to protect us from the Russians. Everybody knows the Russians were going to kill us all. One by one, we were all to be slaughtered in our sleep. That particular narrative was all true. Why do you think they didn't? Imagine planning to kill people who can play golf, drive foldable buggies, and operate color television equipment from 237,000 miles away, for 3 whole days on battery power, in temperatures touching 260 degrees Fahrenheit in a vacuum. This was the early 1970s. The Russians hadn't even worked out how to play golf on Earth yet. They were fucking terrified. And so, decided not to kill us. Uncle Neil saved us, he saved everyone. Some parts of that technology they did have. Occasionally, in secret, they went to the moon and played golf. Deep down, that technology terrified us all. And it had to be destroyed. That's what they did. They took it to that volcano in the Canary Islands, and they threw that technology in the lava, and they destroyed it. They knew it had to be destroyed. I'm glad of that now. They needed to focus on Mars, and leave all that moon golf behind. But, do you know what? The boy is right. This isn't a spaceship. Just look at it. The boy isn't a witch. We shouldn't burn him. Not on this night. There has been enough of that. Then one of the Welsh villagers decided to speak.
What if you're wrong? I read on the internet that Neil was also taking performance-enhancing drugs, and that's why he was able to fly to the moon. Anyways, I don't trust you. My friend says you're not a real person. Your voice sounds computer-generated. He thinks you're an agent.
Billy Armstrong swiftly shut him down. That's disinformation, you fucking idiot. Be quiet. Then he continued. Listen, it's like the Emperor's new clothes. You know, that story about the Emperor. You know, the one who wasn't wearing any clothes, and was walking around naked. Then another heckler said,
What the hell are you on about now? Taking your clothes off? That man was naked in front of children. Are you a pervert?
Then another heckler shouted,
He's gonna take his clothes off. Burn him.
Then fearing for his life, Billy Armstrong swiftly began to defend his observation. No, listen, I'm not on about being fucking nude, it's a metaphor. This Sellotape spaceship silliness just shows how easily people can take up a pretense, and conversely, how easily they can be snapped out of such silly nonsense. It's the psychology of the mob or the majority. Nobody wants to be the lone voice in the wilderness, so, in that respect, it's akin to the Emperor's new clothes, got that? I'm not saying being naked in front of children is okay. Then much to Billy's relief, one of three female trumpet players who were practicing nearby, put down her trumpet, and said,
Yes, Billy. It works as an idiom and an allegory on that level. You're right, it happens all the time in political and cultural situations, we can see that. You weren't threatening to take your clothes off and have a good time, we can see that now.
Then a slender black man with shiny hair appeared and in a high-pitched shrill tone said,
We don't have to take our clothes off to have a good time, Oh no. We should dance and party, all night. And drink some cherry wine,
Fuck are you on about?
Somewhat relieved, Billy Armstrong broke a smile. And said, Do you know what? That's a really good idea. Eventually, one by one, all across the land, everyone joined in laughing at the silly Sellotape spaceship, the Welsh, the Shire folk, the TV watchers. Eventually the whole world joined in. Most of them were so embarrassed they pretended they never even believed in the silly Sellotape spaceship in the first place. Then everybody danced, all night, and partied, and drank some cherry wine, Somebody played guitar. Then three girls played trumpets. And they all laughed and 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 laughed. Then they all turned their television sets off, and lived happily ever after. The end.